In the start of excavations, people didn't screen at all. So maybe between like the 1880s and the 1980s, screening was not included or wasn't included systematically. And I'm pretty sure in like the French archaeological lore, the sieving really started because they were missing all the small ornaments. That if you were just excavating and throwing the dirt behind you and picking out the really big bones or really big stone tools, you were missing like really beautiful artistic symbols of personal ornamentation. So they started sieving. Now that we know that screening gives us like a lot of information, it is absolutely the standard across most excavations and most time periods. But with sieving, you get all these other tiny pieces, often not included in analyses, bones. But they weren't typically included in analyses because there was no morphological markers on them, right? You couldn't tell if it came from a femur or a crania or a vertebra because they had nothing on them. They look like cornflakes. And I want to share with you some really good pictures. And by good pictures, I mean it looks like a mess of crap, but because it doesn't automatically lend itself to the typical archaeological analyses or lithic analyses, they are not heavily exploited. But that's where I get to come in and use them for my analyses.